Hello everyone! This time I'm not going to make a resin painting, but I'm going to show you how I seal my acrylic pour with resin. The resin I'm using is from the Dutch company again, but then a different one than I use for the freeform resin flower. This one sets much faster. I have a working time of about 45 minutes, so that's good. And I made this painting a month ago, so it's dry enough to apply the resin. And what I did first is clean it with Dawn dish soap 3 times, so that I remove the silicone that's on the top of my acrylic pour. Because if there is still silicone on top, then the resin won't stick to it. And after that, I cleaned it with a little bit of alcohol again, and I let it dry again. And now it's dry enough to apply the resin. So I already poured the resin on top of these 2 paintings, and now I'm spreading it out with my silicone spatula to the sides. And I hope this will dry okay. Adding a little bit more to the sides, and then let it flow over the side. Yeah, and it's very important that you clean your acrylic pour, if you use silicone, very well, because otherwise you get dry spots if the silicone is not removed well enough. Now I'm using some heat to make it more liquid so that it will flow over the side. Adding more to the sides. Yeah, what I already said, I'm using the resin of a Dutch company. It's called Harion Polyester and Epoxy. I will also add the link in the description box so you can check out if you are curious which resin I'm using. And I want to see how this works as a top coat. It's thinner than a stone coat, art coat I'm using, but they said that it will dry like glass, so I'm very curious if it does. Working on the sides. Yeah, and the acrylic pour dried very well, no cracks, it's just okay. So, and I wanted to add this resin layer because I think the colors will be much more beautiful if I have a resin layer on top of it. I'm using my fingers to spread it over the sides. I will also link the video of how I made these 2 paintings. Then you can see I used color art primary elements for these 2 paintings, so then you can see how I did that. The torch for the air bubbles. I must say there are not many air bubbles in this resin, so that's also a positive thing. So I'm almost done, and then I will let it dry, and then we will see if it all works, if it went okay. Yeah, it's dry and I need to add a second layer because I had dry spots. So that means I didn't remove the silicone well enough from my acrylic pour. And I had them most on the sides and in the brown blue area. So not in the middle part. So that means what I already said, I didn't remove the silicone well enough. So what I did, I let it dry again for a week. And then I cleaned the spots with some Dawn dish soap again. After that, I used alcohol. And then I sanded it with sandpaper 400 grit. I cleaned it again with some alcohol, let it dry. And now I can add the second layer. And I hope that this time it's okay. So what I already mentioned, it's important that you remove the silicone, otherwise you get dry spots. So I'm using the same resin again, the resin from Harion epoxy and polyester, and I'm spreading it with my silicone spatula again. So I wasn't that happy with my first layer, but no problem, I can add a second layer, because I like these paintings a lot, so they need to be perfect. Also, for the Paint It Forward campaign, I want to mention Clara Lawrence. She does some amazing things with alcohol, inks and resin. She made a beautiful horse and a dragon. So I will link her YouTube channel in the description box. And if you are curious, go check her out, her YouTube channel. She does amazing work. Maybe subscribe to her channel. She will like that a lot. Adding more to the side, spreading it with my fingers. Torch for the air balls, and then I'm done again with this second layer, and then I will show you all a close-up. So this is the end result, and it went okay after the second layer. So no dry spots anymore, so if you are going to apply a resin layer on your acrylic pours, make sure that you remove the silicone very well, and because otherwise you get the same what I had. But they look great now. There you can see it. I'm trying to show you in different angles how flat they are, because this epoxy or resin is totally flat. It's just like glass. Very nice. There I'm trying to show you all, but it's so difficult to film this. But if you like what I'm doing, please subscribe to my channel, give me a thumbs up for this video. If you have tips, comments or questions, place them under the video. Don't forget to check out the YouTube channel of Clara Lawrence. I will link it in the description box. And you can also find me on Facebook and Instagram. Also, those links are in the description box. Also from my Etsy shop and my Amazon Influencer store. I want to thank you all for watching again. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.